This is the lecture number 8 for the chapter sequence series for class 11th. And in the last lecture, we have done up to question number 15 of exercise 9.3. Now, in question number 16, it is given that you have to find a GP whose sum of first two terms is given. The sum of first two terms is given, that is a plus r is given as equal to minus 4. And the fifth term is given as 4 times is third term. It means we have given two equations in terms of GP. This is the first. So AR raised to power 4 will be equal to, and the third term will be AR square. So you can take AR square common. So it will be R square minus 4. It will be equal to 0. So this is given as in question number 16, that is the sum of first two terms is given as minus 4, which is a 1 plus r is equal to minus 4, and it is given that fifth term is four times is third term. So this will be cancelled out, and r square is equal to 4, and r will be equal to plus minus 2. So when r is equal to 2, then a will be equal to 1 minus 2 will be equal to minus 4, and in that case a will be equal to 4. Now if r is equal to minus 2, then in that case put it here, so a will be 1 minus 2 is equal to minus 4. It will be minus 2, that is plus 2. Solve it. It will be minus 2 here, and if we take plus 2, a will become minus 4 upon 3. This is the first term and the common ratio in the different condition. So you are getting the two case. The first case is if r is 2 and a is minus 4 upon 3. So in that case, the GP will be AR square and so on. The first term is minus 4 upon, and the GP will comes out to be minus 4 upon 3. Then A into R, that is minus 8 upon 3 and minus 16 upon 3 and so on. If the first common ratio is 2 and first term is minus 4 upon 3. Now similarly, you can find the GP in the second case if r is equal to minus 2, and in that case a is equal to coming out to be 4. So GP will be a, that is 4, a into r, that is minus 8, a into r square, then it will be 16 and so on like this. So you're getting two sets of geometric progression in the different conditions. Now in see it once more. Now in question number 17, it is given that if the fourth term, the 10th term and the 16th term of the GPs are given, you read the question x, y and z. It is given. Now you have to prove that x, y, z in GP. Now when you have to prove that this x, y, z in GP, that is you have to prove y square is equal to x into z. The square of the middle term is equal to product of first and last. And this is just same question as third we have done in the beginning of this exercise. Now if the fourth term is given as x, so it means AR cube is equal to x. If 10th term is given, that AR raised to power 9 equal to y. And if 16th term is given, AR raised to power 15 is equal to z. So therefore, the left hand side will be y, put the value of y, AR raised to power 9 ka square, which is a square r raised to power 18. Find the right hand side, with x is AR raised to power 3, and AR raised to power 15 is the value of z. This is AR raised to power 18, so a square r raised to power 18, so they are both equal to each other. So we can say that y square is equal to x into z. This is the question number 17. Somewhat easy question this is. See it very carefully. Question number 18. This is the fixed question. That is, you have to find the sum of this sequence up to n terms, n times. So in these types of question, you simply what you have to do, you have to say, first of all, take common the number which is given. N times you have to find the sum. Then you have to multiply and divide by 9. These types of questions more are given in the miscellaneous exercise. And like this, up to n times you have to find the sum. Then this is a, for 9 you can write 10 minus 1. For 99 you can write 100 minus 1. For 999 you can 1000 minus 1. For this 999 you can 10 to the power 4 minus 1. And up to n times. Now you can separate into two series. It is 8 upon 9. So 10 plus 10 square plus 10 cube up to n times. And this minus 1 is added 1 times, n times. Take minus common, n times. So when you add 1 to n times, it will be equal to n. And this is a GP up to n terms. It will be a r raised to power n minus 1 upon r minus 1. This is the sum of first n terms of a GP, where first term is 10 and the common ratio is also equal to 10. Now you can simplify as far as possible. So it will be 10 upon 9. So 80 upon 9 square, 10 to the power n minus 1, and 8 upon 9 into n, that is 8 n upon 9. So this is the sum of 8 n terms of this given sequence, which is a special sequence, we can say. So this is the fixed type of question you have to do. Many questions are there in the miscellaneous exercise. First off, you have to take the number which is given as common. Then you have to multiply and divide by 2 and then convert into GP by adding or subtracting something. So for 9, you can write 10 minus 1. For 99, you can write 100 minus 1 and so on. Question number 19. You have to find the sum of the product of the sequence corresponding term. The two sequence are given as it is 2, 4, 8, 16 and 32. It is a GP if you say it. And 128, 32, 8, 2, 1 upon 2. So multiply the corresponding terms. You have to find the sum of their product. 4 into 32, 8 into 8, 16 into 2, 32 into 1 upon 2. So the first term is 128 divided by 2, 256. And the common ratio is 4 into 32 upon 2 into 128, 2, that is 64, that is 1 upon 2 you are getting. And how many terms are there? 5 terms are there. So you have to find the sum as 1 minus r raised to power n upon 1 minus r. You can find the sum where the n is given, which is equal to 5, r is given, 1 upon 2, and the first term is given as 256. So what can you conclude from this? If the two series, two terms are in geometric progression, if we find the product of their corresponding terms, we will always get a geometric progression, which we have to prove in the question number 20 as well. So you have to in question number 20. So have a look on it. First of all, question number 19. Now in question number 20, it is you have to show that the two geometric progressions, first is this and another is this. You have to prove that the product of their corresponding terms, means you have to find the product A into A, A into A, R into R, A into A, R square into R square, and so on. You have to prove that this is forming a geometric progression. Now, how can you prove that they are forming the geometric progression? If we if we show that their geometric ratios are same, so common ratio of this, you divide this by first a, this is a into a, r into r, which is a into a, that is r into r. Now if we divide this third term by second, we find another common ratio, and if it is equal to same, then we can say that it is a geometric progression. So when you divide it, you are also getting r into r. Therefore the product of the corresponding terms of two geometric progression also form a geometric progression. These are the two questions we have just done. In question number 19, the exact numbers are given. In question number 20, the general geometric progressions are given. Question number 20, this is. See it. Now, in question number 21, now what is given in question number 21? Find four members forming a geometric progression, which the third term is, it is given that greater than the first term by 9, and the second term is greater than the fourth term by 18. You have to find the first four members of the geometric progression. So in this, you will get the two equations which will be solved by dividing the equation. The third term is AR square, first term is A, 9. You can take A common, this is the first equation. Second term is AR, fourth term is AR cube is equal to 18. So you can take A common, so it will AR common, so it will be AR square 18. Now you can divide these two equations, that is AR 1 minus R square upon A R square minus 1 will be 18 divided by 9. Now if you see it carefully, you take minus common, you are getting minus R and 8, that is 2. So R is coming out to be minus 2. Now you can put in any equation or 1 or 2 as R as minus 2. So it will be 4 minus 1 will be equal to 9. So A is coming out to be 3. So this is the first term and the common ratio, and you have to find the term, first four terms, A, AR, AR square, AR raised to power 3. First four terms you have to find. The first term is 3. Second term will be A into R, that is minus 6. The next term will be A minus 2 ka square, and the next will be A minus 2 ka cube. So 3 minus 6, 12. And this is minus 8, minus 24, and so on. So this is the first four terms of the geometric progression. Have a look at it. Question number, this is 21. Now in 22nd, in question number 22nd, it is a good question, see it very carefully. The pth term is given as A, the qth term is given as B, and the rth term is given as C. And you have to prove that, A raised to power Q minus R, B raised to power R minus P, and C raised to power P minus Q is equal to 1. This you have to prove. So let here in geometric progression, the first term be capital A, and common ratio be capital R, because small a and r is given. So the pth term will be A, r raised to power p minus 1 will be equal to A. The pth term, the rth term will be A, r raised to power q minus 1 is equal to B, and the rth term will be A, r raised to power r minus 1 is equal to C. So these are the values of small a, b, c's, where we have let the first term be capital A and the common ratio is capital R. So replace the values of A, B, C, which is A, R raised to power P minus 1, K power Q minus R. B is A, R raised to power Q minus 1, K power R minus P. And C is A, R raised to power R minus 1, K power P minus Q. Now you have to prove that this is equal to 1. Now, if you see it on multiplication, the powers of the bases have the same base will be added. तो ए रेज टू पावर वी विल बी क्यू माइनस आर प्लस हेयर ए रेज टू पावर आर माइनस पी प्लस ए रेज टू पावर पी माइनस क्यू. दिस इज द पावर ऑफ ए व्हेन वी एड इट. सिमिलरली द पावर ऑफ आर विल बी पी माइनस क्यू इंटू क्यू माइनस आर प्लस क्यू माइनस वन इंटू आर माइनस पी एंड हेयर आर माइनस वन इंटू पी माइनस क्यू. सो दीज आर द पावर्स ऑफ ए एज वेल एज आर. यू टेक योर टाइम, इट इज वेरी सिंपल. इन दिस ऑल टर्म्स विल बी कैंसल आउट. तो विल गेट ए रेज टू पावर जीरो. इन दिस ऑल्सो वेन यू मल्टीप्लाई एंड ओपन द ब्रैकेट्स हेयर this you'll get all term will be cancelled out, it will be coming out to be 0. So a raised to power 0 1 r raised to power 0 1, so it is equal to 1, which is the right hand side. So this is the question number 22. We have done the pth term, the qth term and the rth term of a GP is given, and I've let it here the first term as capital A and the common ratio as capital R. So pth term will be a r raised to power p minus 1, qth term will be a raised to power a r raised to power q minus 1, and the rth term is equal to a r raised to power r n minus 1 is equal to c, and replace the values of a, b, c in the left hand side in which you have to prove. So I have replaced the values of a, b and c, which is this, this and this. When you multiply the and the same base, the power of a will be added. The power of a here is q minus r, r minus p and p minus q, which will be added, and the power of r will be added. The power of r is p minus 1 into q minus r plus q minus 1 into r minus p. This is q minus 1 and it is r minus 1 plus into q minus 1. When you open the bracket, all the powers will be cancelled. You will get a raised to power 0, r raised to power 0, which is equal to 1 into 1 and 1. So we'll discuss in the next lecture. Thank you.